In April this year, Parliament passed the Electricity Amendment Bill 2022 with heavy penalties of vandalism, including 1 billion shillings fine or a 15-year jail term for anyone who is found guilty of vandalizing electricity infrastructure. However, 6 months later, Parliament's Committee on Natural Resources is concerned that even the deterrent penalties have not helped to tame vandalism.
It is certainly we put in very stringent measures in the law to have deterrent actions. But we see, even when we have just passed the new law, the vandalism seems to be increasing. So like all other agencies of government, particularly security agencies, need to up the game.
Governments have not been deterrent enough. Indeed, they have not been a deterrent at all. What is happening is that vandalism has escalated.
The committee chairperson, Dr. Emmanuel Otala, says vandalism of electricity pylons has escalated mostly because it's perpetuated by insiders of agencies mandated with distribution of electricity.
And we believe that this is something which is happening internally. It must be arising from the people who know how to handle power. Because when you see a high-powered pylon of 400 kilovolts being tampered with, then you know the people who are really doing the vandalism are from internally.
According to the Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited's data on vandalism, 52 electricity transmission towers have been destroyed by vandals along the corridor between Bujagali Hydropower Dam and Kakira Sugarcane Plantation alone in the past 15 months. On top of that, transmission cables spanning more than 16 kilometers have been cut off and stolen by vandals. This has been mostly blamed on the growing scrap industry.
Because they know that the cost of selling scrap is more paying than the penalty. And so it's a multi-sectoral matter, and we want to bring every sector on board so that this matter is discussed.
Now the Committee on Natural Resources wants to visit Kenya to benchmark on policies and technology that has been used to cover vandals. MPs claim Kenya had a similar challenge with Uganda, but they have been able to mitigate it.
Important to learn from those that have done it very well, so that we can be able to bring the knowledge in our country to ensure that our electricity sector is very stable and it continues to play a significant role in socio-economic transformation.
Also, we want to take a leaf from Kenya. Our brothers in Kenya have totally banned the scrap industry, and that's how they have been able to curb vandalism of electrical installations. So we shall also take a leaf from them.
While interfacing with officials from the Ministry of Energy, the committee chairperson, Dr. Otala, begged the Ministry of Energy to finance the MP's visit to Kenya to benchmark on vandalism of electricity installations.
The case of Kenya is a clear one in that regard. It may please you to sponsor a benchmarking trip for this committee and yourself to Kenya so that we see what have they done. The scrap industry must be brought to order.
By practice, it is irregular for parliamentary committees to be sponsored by ministries or any other agency under their supervision, as it may compromise the integrity of MPs to carry out oversight. Report by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.